Hello, I'm Stewart Munro. I'm the Assistant Secretary of the Department of Finance, working on the GovERP program. So it's a large enterprise resource planning project that's live in government at this time. Robotic process automation is a digital technology tool that mimics human interaction to complete an end-to-end process by interacting with multiple systems. So it sits on the automation continuum between very much a business process automation and like a macro in Excel, all the way up to the continuum goes all the way up to artificial intelligence. And so it sits more down towards the highly structured data sets, rules-based, predictable pathways side of that continuum. The benefits are that it has increased accuracy of processing, reliability, auditability, and it can be run unattended overnight, so it frees up humans to do what humans do best, to value add for the citizens of Australia through their government services. So RPA is used in the Department of Finance in its shared services context through the Service Delivery Office, and it's used across key components of payroll, accounts payable, accounts receivable. And what it looks at there is data matching. It also does reconciliation activities and progressing end-to-end processes like the payment run, which happens on a daily cycle for multiple activities, which has multiple handoffs between agencies as well as data going to banking. And so it uses banking files, can encrypt things and move it through the process with limited human intervention, which improves efficiency, reliability and auditability of that process. So how can you get involved? The Productivity and Automation Centre of Excellence, so housed in the Department of Finance, is a whole of government initiative around getting people that are interested in automation, are leaders in automation, together and having the conversation around the tools, around the industry, and around the benefits and applications and sharing lessons learned. In terms of how can you get involved as an individual, there's probably two that I'd reference specifically. One is around the community of practice, that is under the Productivity and Automation Centre of Excellence, PACE. And that's at where a gathering, digitally and in person, that happens on a semi-regular cadence, at least quarterly, where across EL and APS staff, executive level and APS staff, and they meet and talk about their experience, what they're interested in, and what types of opportunities exist in the marketplace. The second one I'd say is look at the Digital Transformation Agency's website. We've got our career pathfinder there, and there's been some great work with the Australian Public Service Commission and the Digital Transformation Agency and Finance in constructing what robotic process automation, what that career pathing looks like as a developer, as an automator, and as some of the key governance roles. And so that might put you in a good stead to understanding, do you have the capabilities or the interests to really push down a career in RPA? So in understanding what processes can or can't be automated, I'd first look at, is it a highly structured process? Is it understood with clear rules and clear handoff points? And is it clearly documented? And has that process been refined and reviewed? So I'd look at that first. Secondly, I'd look at, what are the inputs to the process and the outputs? Is it structured data? Is it digital data? And how does that, so you can ingest it easily, and then you can kick it out using your key systems and going through so the flow is unaffected. The third I'd look at is the repeatability of the process. So does this process run minutely? Does it run hourly? Does it run daily? Does it run annually? Though obviously the return on investment is that for the first three that I mentioned, and if it's running annually, you'd have to understand what is the return on investment in terms of this automation. And in the fourth part I'd look at is, does this process rely on a number of manual interventions or keystrokes where individuals and people have to manually enter data on multiple systems, or what we call in the industry swivel chairing? So looking at one system, copy and pasting data into another system, that would show that there's a high value in around auditability and around accuracy that's going to come from the process. The future of RPA to me looks like going from one end of the continuum to the high end of the continuum. What I mean by that is going from a strictly rules-based, so very structured data, structured rules and structured inputs, very much starting to couple with cognitive capabilities to push it up more towards the artificial intelligence stream. We're seeing this from the technology providers themselves in their acquisitions of certain companies, and also looking at major technology providers in terms of platforms acquiring RPA technology or robotic process automation technology companies to augment and fulfill different needs in their platforms. So for a visual, I see that the robots are going to get eyes, ears, probably not noses, but definitely mouths, and start becoming more and more equipped to do more and more high-end value-based decisions and helping being strategic partners for APS colleagues more broadly.